So, sir, you are a seasoned professional. You have been in the business for many, many years, and I'm sure you have seen several business cycles. Despite that, I'm sure there are something new this time. So, I wanted to understand from you, what are the top three organizational priorities, for you right now?
You see, the situation today, what we are seeing because of the health issues, especially the corona or virus or COVID-19. But in lifetime, if you see in so many years of my experience, I mean, if not the COVID type of issue, but I have gone through a couple of hurdles, like, the overall recession in the country, overall recession in the world. It has been, I mean, people always remember 2008, but prior to 2008, the conditions were much worse in some of the other years. When India was in 1991, India was facing a very acute shortage of foreign exchange. When Prime Minister Mr. Chandrasekhar, he had to pledge the gold, physically the gold, to British banks. And that situation was more precarious than today, because at that time media was not there, people were not knowing, financial knowledge per se was not available with the people. So I think today we are in a better stage. Country, of course, when we compare country that what it used to be 1 year back and what it is today, we feel yes, we are in a dilemma. But I'm very a very positive person. I think there's a great opportunity for all of us to come forward and to rebound, and we can definitely bring the economy back to the wheels. So if we compare the early 90s versus 2020 today, we are still better. If we compare 2000 versus 2020, we are still better. If we compare up to 2005, we are still better. If we compare the 2008 worldwide economy melted down, people say the great Lehman Brothers, everybody used to cite this example, we are still better. So I think we are better. We are much better. So the situation, the industries, my message to all of the professionals, the executives, and the industrialists is that this is a momentarily temporary cloud which is receding now. And this is going to teach us so many things in life in times to come. We have discovered so many new ways to live. And I'm not worried. We can go ahead. So what are the key task today for any organization, especially Jindal Steel and Power? Our first task is we have to run. We have to keep on working. The second task is we have to run and we have to make some profit. The third task is we have to look or hunt for the opportunities. So wherever we feel that we can earn money here, so we should hunt those opportunities and we should earn the money there. So these are the three tasks what I am taking for my company today.
Wonderful,
So
wonderful.
in these three tasks, the first and foremost is how to utilize 100% capacity of the plant. So 100% capacity utilization means this can only be possible when you can sell all 100%.
Right.
So today, fortunately, for the last so many months, we have created a vacuum. We can sell whatever we produce of 120% of that we can sell. So that means the production is always short. So today we have orders of 500,000 tons of exports. And but we can take 600,000 also. We could take 700,000 also. We didn't take, we have stopped booking for the last 15 days. We have not booked any order. So today we have created a vacuum in between production and marketing. So marketing is more aggressive now, and we are ramping up the production to meet out the marketing requirement. So this is our biggest task.
Okay. And sir, how comfortable are you on the supply side? I mean, how is the support from the vendors? Do you find disruptions in the supply chain, or you have been getting material and it's getting connected as you need it?
You see, the world is living in the proximity effect. There are two effects in life. One is called skin effect. The other is called proximity effect. The skin effect, what is skin effect? First, I'll tell you. The skin effect is when there is a business or people, then we have some sort of wavelength from one skin to another skin, and we get influenced out of that. The other is the proximity effect. The proximity effect is, as we, there's an old Hindi saying, kharbuje ko dekh ke kharbuja rang palatta hai. Means if there are kharbujas, watermelon, or muskmelon in the field, so one is getting to its full stage of it is ripe fully. So the other is also going to maintain the same thing, because the smell creates the other kharbuja into a fully ripe condition.
Mm-hmm.
So this is how the business is. In businesses, the biggest factor today is the confidence. So when you do something, I try to do the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
And when we two together, we do something, then other 20 people, they try to do something.
Right.
So that is the effect in a business that is called a proximity effect.
Mm-hmm.
The skin effect is limited to a very less number of people. But proximity effect is like a corona. I mean, one person can affect 200 people, and 200 can 200,000. And 200,000 can millions.
Yeah.
So it's the same thing is in business. If I do business, so Tata will also start doing the business. When Tata starts business, JSW also start doing the business. And this is what has happened in the country. The basic purpose of theory of constant is that how to survive under constants.
Yeah.
So if you cannot survive under constants, that means you have not learned the TOC. So I have given definition to all of my team that TOC means how to run with so many constraints, how to run, not to stop. I'm glad to tell you that we are going to do our highest production in April.
That's really nice. And that's wonderful.
You see, the country is melting because of Corona. Fortunately, touch wood, the grace of God, we are going to record production and record sales. No credit. Zero credit, all 100% backed by confirmed letter of credit, LCs.
Yeah.
So all the money is in hands. So this means what? That you are running your institution 100% on exports, at least 80-85% exports, and we are running comfortably, and we will do the ever highest production also, and ever highest sales also.
Mm-hmm.
So I have given a mantra to our people, produce as per orders. And sales, to salespeople, sell whatever is produced. So the mantra is, produce only as per orders.
Yeah.
And sell whatever is produced. I mean, marketing people cannot say that I wanted product A to come first and product B to come later. But plant has given me product B first and A later.
Mm.
No problem. We will sell it.
Okay.
So, but it is because B is also against order.
Mm-hmm.
So if some Liberty plant has taken, they have taken as per their convenience because of the certain reason. So we always tell them it's okay. No problem.
Mm.
So produce as per orders.
Yeah.
And sell whatever is produced.
Yeah.
And this mantra we have taken, and we have found we have been successful. For the last so many months, we have zero stoppage because of any resources.
And I'm sure that has now really been helpful now with the lockdown being extended. So the groundwork has already been done. There are no questions. It's business as usual. And people are able to
Work
in the same way.
Actually, I picked up the words of Mr. Pradhan, the steel minister. In the month of February, he gave a statement in all leading newspapers of this country, you can find on the Google also, that this corona effect is going to stay for 2 to 3 years in world. So it's a good opportunity for the Indian steel mills, because he's a steel minister, Indian steel mills to position themselves for the exports. Mm-hmm. So when a cabinet minister is speaking something, it has given me a point to think that what does he say? Then I started doing little research with the help of my associates that what is going to happen. We found that China, their steel mills are running at 50% capacity. Vietnam is running 50% capacity. Philippines is running about 50 to 60% capacity. So I found that, look, the moment China recovers, they will be hungry. And they will be needing a lot of raw materials and a lot of steel. And same thing happened. When China declared, yes, we are out of the danger, so they declared 20 million ton shortage of steel. So this means they cannot export and they have to import. So from February onwards, we started building up the orders. February, my closing orders were 300,000 tons. And March, we have taken another 300,000 tons. April till now, we have taken 100,000 tons. So total 700,000 tons. We already delivered 200,000 tons, 250, I would say, from till now. Mm-hmm. So 450,000 tons are yet to be delivered. By 30th of this month, we'll deliver another 300,000 tons. Mm-hmm. So we'll be left with 150,000 tons. So 15th May, we'll finish all these 150,000 tons. Yes. So this is what the scenario is.
And of course, you will be booking more orders as the backlog.
Today we have made a different strategy. If the lockdown is lifted on 3rd, then by 15th, the country's economy should come on rails. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, if it does not, then we'll book more orders again for exports. So we have in this company, we were not exporting so much. Mm-hmm. So today we are exporting more than 400,000 tons a month. It is a, mm-hmm. it's a very respectable figure. Mm-hmm.
That's really interesting. I mean, especially, you know, the fact that you did not have so much focus on exports earlier. So any suggestion for Indian companies, you know, now as companies are preparing during, what can they do during this lockdown or post-lockdown, especially from also, you know, if you can share some pointers on how they can manage their cash flows?
It is very simple. You tell me which kind of industry, then I will reply you that. You ask me the question because there are so many industries.
Let's say automotive, which anyway has been really under.
Automotive, if I were to decide today, if I am the CEO of any big automotive company, then I'll be the happiest person today. How? Today the whole country is sitting at home. But in last so many weeks, I have not seen even one advertisement in any of the newspapers or any of the TV. Hmm. Promoting any vehicle. This is agony. They all have thought that we are dying. If I were to decide, then every 10 minutes there'll be ad on television that these are the new cars available, these are Bharat 6 cars available, Bharat 6 compliant cars available, and this is available at this much of lakhs rupees, this is available at this much of lakhs rupees. The moment COVID-19 is out or the situation is improved and you are allowed to buy, mm-hmm. so we will deliver the car at your residence. Today, you just pay 10,000 rupees and book the car. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Nobody has done it.
Not at all.
What happened? And nobody has done it. That means what? That means they don't trust the economy. They don't trust the people. Mm-hmm. Everybody is asking that now there will be job loss. Everybody is asking that people, they will their salaries will be reduced. Everybody is thinking that this is the end of the world, but I don't think so.
Yeah,
there is a big, big amount of opportunity which is existing today. Mm-hmm. So the auto people, they have lost the boat. They have mm-hmm. missed the boat, I would say.
Yeah.
Last 8 weeks of time was the superb time when you entered in April. It was end of March, mm-hmm. a new financial year. And then this was the right time mm-hmm. to make the bookings and to sell the goods.
Right. Yeah.
So and they already missed the boat.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. You know, there is an assumption that salaries would be cut. But, you know, yesterday also it was there in the news, Capgemini has actually, they have announced a moderate increase, but they're not cutting salaries. So it is not necessary that all companies, all sectors, we will see some of
this. There is no point in cutting the salaries. So we were discussing about the auto industry, correct?
Right. Yeah.
So auto industry has lost eight good weeks.
Yeah. Yeah.
So if you have your clients as auto industries, you must ask them that you please declare the schemes.
Mm-hmm.
And today you book.
Yeah.
Because this is not the end of the world.
Mm.
Reason being, because people will not travel through the public transport, those who can afford.
Yeah.
There's a big shift. Okay. If they can manage with motorcycle, they will buy motorcycles, scooters, or four-wheelers, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
But they will travel alone.
Yeah.
So this is a big change.
Yeah.
People will not hire drivers to avoid this pandemic.
Right.
The situation is changing now.
Mm-hmm.
The country will come to self-driven mode.
Right.
People will not travel in the buses.
Mm-hmm.
Because this corona effect is not going to get away till the vaccine is developed.
Right.
This may take 1 year, this may take 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
People will start buying more and more vehicles.
Mm-hmm.
That means the industry will flourish. That means the component industry will flourish. And mm-hmm. that means the mother raw material industry will flourish.
Okay.
So this is going to happen. Mm-hmm. But if they are already under gloom mm-hmm. and they say that we are dead now, then it is a suicidal for them.
Mm-hmm.
They must come forward that we are not dying mm-hmm. and we are a very vibrant sector, mm-hmm. automotive sector.
Mm-hmm.
Then things will change.
Mm-hmm.
Like steel. So steel, we cannot meet out the steel in country's steel demand. And because the demand will be too big
mm-hmm.
and we cannot supply the material.
Mm-hmm.
Because the whole world has gone to capacity reductions. Like Japan has reduced 25% capacity.
Mm-hmm.
Korea has reduced 25% steel capacity. Europe has reduced 25 to 30% capacity. China is already, they are already at less, I mean 25, 30% less today. They are buying steel. So that means who will supply steel to India? So it's a great amount of future, good future for India.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
See, crops are very good. It is 28% economy comes from crops. So there's a bumper crop we are seeing today.
Mm-hmm.
Haryana, Punjab, Western UP, Madhya Pradesh, and Chhattisgarh, heavy crops. So that 28% to 30% economy is secured. Country has already started exporting food grains to the rest of the world because there is a big market existing because they are dying.
Yeah.
People are eating more food. So when people are eating more food sitting at home, so India has got a very ready market. So India mm-hmm. has started exporting food grains.
Yeah.
The point number two, in last total 2 months of COVID in India, people have saved at least 80% of their salaries if they are getting full. Because there are no other expenses. People are not going outside. People are not buying clothes, shoes, cosmetics, other items. They're not spending money. There's no avenues to spend the money.
Yeah.
Because what you have to do, you have to just eat the food, that's all, and stay in the house.
Mm-hmm.
So there is a great amount of saving. In the fuel, there is a great amount of saving because we are not using our cars.
Correct.
So there is a great amount of saving in fuels also. Everybody is saving 10, 12,000 rupees per month.
Yeah.
That was the fuel cost in this country, average fuel cost. So that is again a saving. So if somebody is getting full salary and there is no deduction, that means he or she must have earned a lot of money. It's a good time for them. The moment this situation improves
yeah.
and the moment is free, then they will start buying.
Hmm.
When they start buying, then what will happen?
Right.
Demand. That explosion of demand will take place.
Hmm.
So I'm very positive about it. So 28 to 30% of the economy today is coming from agro sector. So that is okay.
Yeah.
Then the IT sector is going to get a great boom.
Correct.
Because America is in trouble. Highest ever deaths have taken place in America.
Yes.
Cumulatively, Europe is in trouble. There are thousands and thousands of deaths have taken mm-hmm. place there. Mm-hmm. So, overall, millions of people are getting affected.
Okay.
So there will be new software coming in, health-related software, health-related apps, health-related business will start through the software business. Then so many, like today we are seeing the services, like accounting services, business services, marketing services, work from home services, like what we are, we and you are chatting today towards Zoom. So these internet services, they will be at its peak for next 2 years' time. So there'll be a very big business for the startups and also for the matured companies like TCS, Infosys, Wipro, or HCL. So that's again a good business for the people will get. So that economy is also about 25 to 30% of ours.
Yes.
So that means the GDP, whatever the GDP contribution comes into GDP from IT sector and also from the agro sector, that is fully secured. Then comes to manufacturing. Manufacturing, what is the problem? There's no problem because 130 crore people, they will have to buy. They cannot sit idle. So the balance factor, if you see that whatever 60% of GDP, then the industrial sector, manufacturing sector, and then the trading sector. So I think whatever we are saying, okay, today we feel that the our growth GDP will be 1.9% as declared by the World Bank. But I'm sure it will be more than 5%. Not 9%, 1.9%. So nothing to worry about.
The demand is there. The growth story is still there. Yes, this is not, these are not the days of 7-8%. But honestly, I think we also need to look a little beyond the numbers. I mean, the real demand is there. If manufacturing can actually meet those demands, I think the important thing is for manufacturers not to start believing that there is no demand and sort of start cutting back on their own.
You see, first of all, India is a very versatile country. It has so much of population, and India is self-reliant in most of the items. So India can survive and sustain because the market is too big. Market size is too big. We cannot stop buying.
Yes.
Even the mandatory purchases, if we do, we still roll on 5% growth.
Correct.
I mean, it is a country of 130 crore people.
Absolutely.
So how many people are affected because of corona?
Yes.
How many deaths till now?
Absolutely.
Hopefully there will be no deaths now.
Absolutely.
Or very minimum. I mean, total death index, if it remains within 2, 3, 4, 5,000 people, is nothing. Yeah. I mean, so many people, I mean, more than that, people die on the road accidents.
Absolutely. Yes. I mean. Great, sir. So you mentioned that you know you're going to observe till after 3rd May how things happen and then decide on the domestic or export sales. Anything else? Any other plans post the lockdown? Anything specific? Though I realize that you know even during the lockdown you have kept your team motivated and they are all geared up. I mean, yesterday also during the interaction I saw that everyone was quite geared up. Lockdown or no lockdown, we have to do this. But anything else that is planned after the lockdown?
Very simple. Today we are working at 100%. Tomorrow we are 120%.
Wonderful. Yeah.
This is what we want to do.
Yeah, it's very reassuring to hear your thoughts, sir. And you know, through my interactions with the team, also, I mean, you know, I know that they have full faith that if Mr. Sharma says it can be done, it will be done. So all the best to all of you. Thank you very much for this session and please stay safe and take care of your loved ones.
Thank you so much. You're welcome.